Recreational fishing is a multi-billion dollar industry in Florida. That's billion with a B. We are now in the middle of red snapper season, and people like our own Lauren Rottenkrantz caught one over the weekend, and a lot of you did too. In fact, you've sent us some really cool pictures of your red snapper pictures. There's a big one for that little fellow there. In federal waters, you can only fish for red snapper for 4 days this year, and you can only keep one fish per day. And that's because researchers say the species is declining. But what if we could turn that around? One local lab is working to put more red snapper in the Atlantic Ocean. Justin Clark takes us inside.
You are looking at 1,000 red snapper. They're babies, of course. They grow up to be the long sought after recreational fish.
How big is he?
30 pounds.
Dr. Leonardo Ibarra Castro is growing these red snapper at the UF Whitney Marine Lab in Flagler County. His process starts small with fertilized fish eggs, lots of them.
We harvest 19,000 juveniles in 40 days.
Raising red snapper is not easy.
And the first step you need in order to grow snapper is the food for the food it eats, and that's microalgae.
Another tricky part in growing these guys, they eventually eat each other.
They have a characteristic that they are cannibalistic.
So it requires constant babysitting. Once the fish are about 55 days old, like these, Ibarra Castro sends them to other researchers who monitor the rest of their growth. The goal here is to understand what is a healthy ecosystem for the red snapper's food supply and eventually grow and release thousands of red snapper into the ocean for seafood production.
In order to become more sustainable here at home and less dependent on foreign sources.
And more red snapper in the ocean could also boost Florida's $8 billion saltwater recreational fishing industry.
Our goal, I think, here, restocking as much as possible.
Ibarra Castro has done this kind of work around the world in much larger labs and hatcheries.
I am trying to do the same thing here.
Now he's here on the First Coast, starting in a small lab with tiny fish, helping you to hopefully reel in more of the big ones. In Flagler County, Jessica Clark, First Coast News, on your side.